Hey, what's going on, guys? Brian here. Hope you guys are doing well. Hey, running it back today, back-to-back videos. If you guys want to check out the Brian's All Maintenance YouTube channel, you guys can check out the pole barn right there. Bing! The guys just wrapped up with Morton. Couldn't be more grateful, couldn't be more thankful. The pole barn is all done. Well, just because the pole barn is done doesn't mean it's done, if that makes any sense. Because we need concrete, utilities, the loft, garage doors, and a whole lot more. And I don't know if we told you guys this, but we're gonna be moving into our camper here in about a week and putting it on site, like right here. And by the end of the month, it's supposed to go in there. So we'll see how that goes. Anyway, the adventures never end. I feel like a lot of that's self-imposed. Do we do it to ourselves? I think we do. All right, here's what I wanna show you guys. This little house update, it's been a minute. The masons are kicking butt on the exterior stone. The whole home was insulated. We just met with tile guy Kevin, I believe it was Kevin, and I'll try to interject maybe some of those clips that we took with Liz being here, but a lot of progress. By the end of this week, they should be doing drywall, and that is going to 100% change this whole place up and make it feel way more homey, if that makes sense. Let me show you guys a little tour. We'll take you guys with us.
Just to give you guys that sneak peek of the barn, if you wanna check out the other channel. 40 by 60, 10 foot lean-to, Morton Buildings. Took like 3 weeks. We're out at a lawn care trade show last week. Came home to that being finished. How cool is that? All right, so the masons are making their rounds. Prestige Stone Products. Shout out to Stone Pros of Brighton, Michigan. You guys can see this stone looks absolutely beautiful. We love it. We're so in love. We're so grateful for the stone choice. Now that it's kind of dried up on the mortar, it wasn't that dark gray. You can kind of get that better finishing look, and we're really, really grateful for it. Really, really happy for it. By the way, if you guys want a shot of the stone in the natural light, looks beautiful. Just absolutely beautiful. I don't know if it's doing any justice on camera, but hey, if you guys are ever in the area, want to swing by, I'll give you the look. All right, here is our meters. That is our gas meter. That's a pretty chunky dude. Look at that. And then I don't even know what this is. Our Rommet meter, more gas. No gas just yet. 0.0. All right, that's looking pretty cool. Liz was going to go with flower white or white flower, which is the bottom left. We're gonna go with alabaster on the top left. Final answer. It's a little bit more safe. Some of those different tones we're able to maybe work with together on the house a little bit better. And we only saw white flower in the interior. We couldn't get in a good gauge for it for an exterior. So a lot of folks that we know and also photos that we found on Instagram and Pinterest have alabaster. So that's a little bit more of a safe bet. So we're gonna go with that white.
By the way, I know you guys are looking at all the white. You got white, 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 white. Which white do you like the best? That white. All right, so it's all white.
So anyway, that'll look really nice with the stone, and then add some landscaping in there long term, some hydrangeas, some different colored shrubs and bushes, and things should look pretty nice. Get a little front pan here, show you guys what we got going on, and then I'll take you inside. All right, here we go. All right, so here is the interior, and holy cow, it's a lot quieter in here, if you guys can't tell. So you can see all the walls are filled with the insulation now. Look at that. All the ceilings. It is so much quieter in here. It's hard to describe. And you can see the walls here. It's kind of like shaven straight down. Right? So check that out. That's pretty cool. So this is what most of our interior walls probably look like for most of our homes if you took off the drywall and the paint. But maybe you don't get to see the construction process too often in life. I know I haven't. So this is always kind of fascinating to check out and to look at. It is so much quieter in here. You barely get like an echo anymore when it was just kind of more opened up. It's pretty cool. So all that's been done. And we're getting ready to insulate. You can see the spray foam in certain spots for the exterior portions. I know they did it for like the ice dam, like the guy was talking about. Forget his name on the couple videos back. We did an insulation video. But that's all sprayed. All right, pretty cool. Show you guys also the garage. So we actually got to meet the tile guy like I was talking about. I'll clip to that in a second. And he gave us some other suggestions, some things we were incorporating. Check that out. All right, the garage is all done. There you go.
I will say it is surreal seeing the home progress this far. It literally is a dream come true. I can't describe it. any other way. To see how happy Liz is, happier and happier every time we continue to see more progress on the home and give her her dream home, it's like the best thing, best feeling that I don't know if I can describe on a YouTube video. I feel like we're making it, like we're doing it, like we're finally winning. And I just feel like lately, you know, I did an Instagram post. It said like, overnight success 20 years later. And frankly, that's what it kind of feels like this year. 2023 is finally, everything's pulling together, culminating, and it's our year. You know what I mean? One of those deals. I tell you, 2022 felt like we were losing. 2021 felt like we were losing. 2020 with COVID, that was a wild year. Business was up and down, and we were trying to break ground that year. We were losing, and it feels good to finally have a win. You know, a big win, a big house win, family win, and even the barn at the same time. I told my wife, I said, very few people get that opportunity in life. Maybe one or the other. I said, but to do both at the same time, and at our age, I said, very few people. So if you guys don't know, Liz and I didn't come from anything. So this is pretty sweet. We're in the bonus round. All right, I'm probably going to just clip to Kevin really quick with the tile, and then we'll come right on back. Kevin is here, our tile guy. Shelby's here, Liz is here. By the way, we gotta cover this in a second. We got insulation. Don't be mistaken, it's still actually only 48 degrees in here. Almost just fell and died. All right, let's go check it out. Here we go. Favorite child room.
It's called like three different things, so I get confused.
Yeah, that's why I was like the second floor shower.
Yeah.
You realize we had to stop calling it the favorite child room. So we designed the house before we had kids. So we had called it, jokingly called this a favorite child room because it has a, like its own bathroom. And now one day one of our kids is gonna be in the bathroom or in this room and be like, oh, so I'm the favorite child.
Yeah, they're gonna watch back the video. They might figure it out.
My biggest thing is trim everywhere. So like up the walls, the curb, the seat, the door. Did they discuss any of that with you?
No.
Okay. So like Schluter details.
Oh,
you know,
Schluter.
Typically detail. With you guys, we use all Schluter.
All Schluter. And that's so. What we
do. Good old Schluter. What is that?
Should have brought it.
It's just like a metal piece that kind of puts an end to the trim, or not the trim, the tile.
Okay.
So that it's, you're not seeing anything there.
Okay.
Like the edge.
Like the edge.
That's in our bathroom.
That's what we have at the place right now.
Yeah. Is that pretty typical?
I just didn't know if they'd mentioned it to you. There's like 100 different colors. So. If this is the tile you're going with, I can just bring all of the colors, and then when you go to start, you can just pick it up, hold the piece, and go.
Matches the fixtures.
Yeah, if people typically, you know, match their door hinges, or match their sink faucet, or match, you know, the stone in the countertop. It's all a preference thing.
Okay.
Are we good with using countertop for the seat and the curb?
You okay with that?
Yeah, and the seat in the shower.
Yeah. So ideally, they'll cut your vanity top, and then I'll just ask them for the leftovers, and we'll use it to do the curb and the.
Cool.
Well, that's cool.
We did like this thingy, like the tile that goes like this, like a picket fence.
Okay.
She told us to ask you if you're like cool with us putting it vertically because it's harder to line up.
Whatever way you want. We'll put it on backwards if you want. Yeah. No, horizontal stacked, vertical stacked. That's, that's something we can discuss.
Okay.
When this is drywalled and painted and we can come in right on the walls and do our thing.
Cool. Okay.
Today I just kind of wanted to measure and then go through and make sure this is kind of what we're sticking with so that I can.
Yeah.
Either A, order it, or B,
change it up.
Yeah.
Cool. Yep. Do you see anything under that you wouldn't recommend using?
For this bath? No.
No idea.
No. Okay. Penny rounds for the floor is typical. 3x12 tile for the walls. And the outside floor, little hexes.
Are you guys doing tile on the ceilings? In the showers? We recommend it for just like waterproofing it in kind of thing.
Okay.
Master, I would assume we will.
Yeah.
Because I think it's a steamer, but.
Yeah. Master for sure.
Like, it needs to be done.
We didn't.
Yeah.
That's like a need to be done. It's
okay.
Kind of a preference on if you want to do it in all the bathrooms or not. Some houses we do, some houses we don't.
Okay.
So you guys have a wall tile selected. I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Do you want
to
go above?
To go,
oh, okay. Perfect.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
The subway. And then if we, I guess we could just do the same on the ceiling. We just didn't want it to be like wall here.
You didn't want drywall there.
Yeah. So I guess if we just do the subway tile all around.
Okay.
I think the floor here is a little different though. Like she had wrote.
She has two selections.
Yes. This is why we're like, are we driving you crazy yet? Because we thought it'd be cool to do stripes.
Okay.
With the tile.
Wait, so one more time. Kevin, you're saying the orange. What's the orange that we do on the tile?
So all your bathrooms, not just specifically here, but it's all gonna be a curdy.
Okay.
So we're gonna curdy membrane everything. You know, it's a waterproof one shot system. All your drains are already prepped for it.
Cool.
Believe it or not. So.
All right.
That'll be in all your showers.
All right, so here we go to the master.
The important one.
Master. Master. Top priority. Oh, it's so much quieter in here.
I know.
Ooh, you look beautiful.
Thanks.
What's that growing on you?
This is my growth.
Your growth?
His name's Crew.
Crew? Probably get that looked at.
I'm following you. What are we talking about here, Kev?
So the first thing, they noted it as cove. Are we putting base in here somewhere?
What's a base?
They picked out for you like a polished stone and they're big pieces.
On the floor.
So that's the floor.
Yeah.
So not the one she has noted floor. I was very confused.
Oh, one might be for downstairs. Like the real Calcutta is your cat, whatever this word is. That's for up here, and then we got the fake looking of the same downstairs.
Okay, so maybe that's what that is. Maybe goes to the basement.
Is there a basement section? What do we got for basement?
Yeah, she has. Well, I consider the guest the basement.
Yes. Yeah.
There wasn't anything else upstairs.
Yeah.
So you have Olympia, just as this would be the fake stuff.
Yeah.
Out of vintage.
Okay, so I don't know what that is.
Okay, then. Well, I might give her a call. I know her, so let's see what this is.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
You know, cove is technically a base, so I don't know if you were doing some sort of
tile
base. Something behind the tub, some sort of wainscot here.
I don't think so.
Okay.
No. Mm-mm. No, we're good.
Okay, just double checking.
Yeah.
We got another a more intricate mosaic to go in here.
Oh, you don't want to match the shower pan?
No.
Okay. So maybe that's for the
cubby. Is that what that is? Maybe for the cubby?
That
it starts
be.
With an A. What's the A word?
I don't
artistic.
Remember.
Yes. No.
Yeah,
no.
It was an artistic tile mosaic. Like, that was the brand
name. Yeah, but what's the insert cubby called?
A niche.
A niche.
Right here. I don't know. Which I'm assuming.
Thingy. Yeah.
For your soap and shampoo.
You call this a different word from that thing. You learned
alcove?
That one. Alcove. Do you know what that is?
Same thing.
Oh.
Have you ever worked with anyone
an
expert
in modeling? Alcove is up here. A niche
would
is
that
out
be
here.
Yes, there, we couldn't find anything we liked. So would it be okay to order something like this to just go in the space?
Let me see.
Yep.
It's the dots.
Oh,
like,
I thought we went with that fancier stuff.
I wonder if that's this.
It's similar, but different.
I'm not convinced. Because what you put on the floor, you
the
want
floor
it in there.
The floor is hexes, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah. So this was like those flowers.
Right.
Right. So I'm saying instead of the flowers, if we did this, like, this pattern instead in here.
Whatever you think, honey.
Okay. Well, that's not helpful.
Wait, that's always supposed to end marriage fights, right? In conversations.
Castelli, all the marble you picked in here, do you want to use Schluter or do you want to polish all the edges of it?
So, like a stony looking, like how the wall is.
Okay.
I don't know, does that make any sense? You don't even, like the thing, like it, the transition piece to make it blend with this and not be metal.
I could not use one.
You could just like cut pieces and...
Yeah, I could just cut pieces and like... They call it bullnosing the edge, so like rounding the edge a little bit so it looks, so it's just like a smooth transition.
Okay. Like miter.
Like ugly piece, not ugly, but not a piece of metal there.
Yeah, I prefer that.
Okay.
It's like a mitered edge.
Mitered edge.
But different.
It's a bit eerily similar.
You're learning all these words.
It's bullnosed.
Bullnosed. You're bullnosed.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Appreciate that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, comment, subscribe, you getting some insulation in your eye?
I think I have insulation.
You can blame him for hitting the wall with his hat.
Yeah, I did not.
It happened after that.
Don't throw me under the bus, bro. Not my own video.
That's what I'm here for.
There was a fly and I smacked the insulation and up in smoke later.
Okay, so not the... Is the flower going by the wayside?
Oh, shoot. This is where you put the flower, huh?
Yeah, I have a black...
The flower was here, black was here, and then the word
white.
Was here.
Yeah, that's what...
Okay, that's what it was. Let's do that.
It can be changed.
I like the flower.
So the flower's gonna go this
flower
room.
Flower here. Splish or something. And then black.
Okay. Let me see that photo, that word.
Well, this isn't what it...
Well, yeah.
But...
All right, we'll leave a little photo. Cool.
So we're gonna keep the flower here. We'll come up with something here.
Okay. All right, well, I'll probably just show you guys one more quick clip in here and then we'll probably button this thing up. But it's gonna be so cool to see this room transform almost before our eyes over the next 30, 60 to 90 days, right? The bathroom, the steam shower, the tub, all the tile. It's gonna be absolutely beautiful. We cannot wait.
I think that's just where we're gonna have to cut it for today's video. Just a short and sweet one, little tiny update. Once the stone is completely done, I'll do a little 360 on the house. They're about 3/4, 4/5 of the way. I think actually the masons are even out to lunch right now because a lot of stuff looks wet out on the recovered patio. Phantom screens, shout out to those guys. We are moving forward with the phantom screens. That's the roll down screens. All those soffits are up in the covered porch. Let me see if I can just show you guys that actually really quick. That is a couple buck add-on, as you guys can imagine, but it's something you have to incorporate into your build now because I got a build for it with the peak.
Hope you guys can see that. That's where the rollers will go. And also we were talking about this on another video. See how they cut that green right there? This went all the way over, but it would have blocked the rollers. So we shoved the roof line over just 18 inches or so.
And then
They built those roller covers for the big door up there. I don't know if that's showing up at all. Up there you guys can see they have another box for the large roller. It'll be up there, and then not really sure where we're at with this.
But we're gonna do two like 48 inch rollers on both sides, so they might still have to make boxes, or I don't know, we'll figure it out when we get there.
But there you go. All right, we got that metal chicken wire already for the stone. These guys are moving quick. Oh, and we squared off that wall. A lot of you guys were asking about that wall. That's all fixed. That's a new addition, just kind of dead space. All right, and then back to the stone through there.
All right, well, fam, that's all I got for you today. We are 58 degrees in here. Not too bad. I don't know if you guys can see that. 58. Yesterday when we were here, or 2 days ago when we were here, it was like 44 degrees or 42 degrees. That was not cool. Well, it was cool. It was not fun. But any which way, snap your fingers, another week or two, this whole place is gonna look entirely different. We're loving it. We're gonna be on site here in about a week, and just very, very grateful. All right, that's all I got for you guys in today's update. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the vlogs. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the videos. If you guys have any questions, leave us some comments down below. If you guys have any encouragement, leave that down below too. We're praying people. We always take a kind word or a prayer. Thank you guys so much for the love, support, and that's what I got. All right, we'll catch up with you guys here on the next one.